The mainstream media and big tech increasingly care only about advancing their political ideology and protecting only the speech that fits into their specific narrative. The double standards, disdain, and contempt that elites and institutions of influence have for conservatives is increasingly being revealed. For the sake of our discourse, this cannot continue. As a starting point, we must hold accountable those who limit our free speech and the loss of our civil discourse in this country. The American people are alarmed by the effort to censor conservative voices. We're witnessing a constitutional crisis that threatens to erode the First Amendment and silence people across our country. As a Republican, a conservative American who still believes in the Constitution and the core principles on which our country was founded, I refuse to be intimidated by the cancel culture and its dangerous narratives. However, not every American feels free to speak up. Their voices are being lost. Mr. President, this is why this Senate is so important. For 230 years, the U.S. Senate has been the central venue for voicing dissenting views, and it has celebrated the deliberation of issues confronting our nation. You must be the voice for those who can't use theirs. Now is the time. The urgency weighs on our country. If we're serious about uniting, it must be out of respect for diversity, not despite it. Diversity of belief is not monolithic. In 1964, a future President Ronald Reagan spoke to his fellow Americans saying, "You and I have a rendezvous with destiny. We'll preserve for our children this, the last best hope of man on earth, or we'll sentence them to take that last step into 1,000 years of darkness." These sage words echo today. These words are timeless. To my colleagues in the Senate, I urge you to address the dire threats to our First Amendment rights in order to restore every American's faith in our democracy and to help restore our trust in each other. It is the only way to ensure that America, the world's shining city on the hill, a republic admired for centuries, can endure for future generations. I encourage each of you to uphold our uniquely American values and preserve the American dream. And I will continue to champion our party's values from whatever position I occupy. America depends on it. Americans are counting on us to be their voice. For a shy farm girl who was the first in her family to graduate from college, who could have never imagined that one day I would serve as the United States Senator from the great state of Georgia, thank you all. It has been my deepest honor. May God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America. Thank you. I yield the floor.